The world is full of good news.
The following are just a few.
UK Minister for the Middle East, Alistair Burt, commends Palestinian Authority Prime Minister Salam Fayyad and President Mahmoud Abbas on their leadership as he announces a pledge of £17 million to go towards paying teachers' salaries and improved access to clean drinking water.
Russian cosmonauts Dmitry Kondratiev and Oleg Skripochka successfully install a new high-speed data transmission system during a spacewalk outside the International Space Station.
The Asian Development Bank donates $120 million to Tajikistan for improvement of an essential road connecting to Uzbekistan, which is also part of a 7,000-kilometer highway running from Russia to the Persian Gulf.
Egypt's Minister of Electricity and Energy, Hassan Younis, and Indian Minister of New and Renewable Energy, Farooq Abdullah, discuss increasing cooperation in electricity technologies and alternative energy projects between the two countries.
Formosan or Taiwanese President Ma Ying-jeou affirms his administration's commitment to continue dialogue with China in efforts to find solutions to political issues and maintain cross-strait peace.
Addressing some 5,000 Greek Orthodox Christians on the occasion of Theophany, Archimandrite Nektarios Mansour of the Archdiocese in Amman, Jordan, calls for unity and love to prevail among congregants for the well-being of the world.
With her husband's encouragement, Mrs. Ruxana Batul from Mianwali District in northwest Pakistan, who has never been to school, enrolls in the first grade with her sons to fulfill her dream of getting an education.
A recent study by U.S. researchers finds that new CPR devices, which include a device to control airflow into the lungs, as well as a suction cup attachment that improves blood circulation, are shown to improve survival rates up to 53%.
China's top legislator Wu Bangguo meets with parliamentary leaders from Cyprus and New Zealand, Marius Garoyan and Lindsay Tish, respectively, to increase parliamentary exchanges toward a goal of furthering relations with each of the two countries.
The Foreign Ministry of the United Arab Emirates requests its visiting citizens to respect prohibitions on hunting that have been established by the governments of Mauritania and Iraq.